亲爱的弟兄姐妹们，平安。
Shalom, brothers and sisters.
谢谢牧师的鼓励。
Thank you for the encouragement, Pastor.
感谢主，今天我们又再次的回到教会。
We thank God that we can come again together in the church.
奉主耶稣基督的名相聚在一起。
That in the name of Jesus, we can gather together.
带着感恩赞美的心来朝见爱我们的父神。
To come forth with a heart of thanksgiving and full of joy to meet our Lord.
这是何等蒙福的事啊！
It's such a blessing.
尤其是我们还在疫情当中。
Especially now that we're still in the pandemic.
冠病疫情去年冲击了我国的各行各业。
Last year, the COVID-19 pandemic affected all walks of lives.
许多企业商铺都陷入了财务困境。
And a lot of companies and shops were all in financial difficulties.
倒闭的也不少。
And many were closed.
许多百年老店都没能撑住
，and many century-old shops could not survive.
有160年历史的罗明生百货，也许是你最爱的店。
160-year-old Robinson's departmental store may be one of your favorite stores.
也没能够在这次的疫情中熬过去。
It also succumbed to the pandemic.
可能会成为你一时的感伤吧。
It may make many of us sad.
感谢主赐给我们优秀的政府。
We thank God that He has given us an excellent government.
下了重本。
Who has put in a lot of efforts.
投入了近1000亿元，为国人遮风挡雨来面对疫情。
They have invested nearly $100 billion to shield our citizens from the stormy effects of the pandemic.
避免了大规模的失业和公司倒闭。
And hence avoided large-scale unemployment and the closures of companies.
感谢主，今年一月底，本地居民的就业率就已经恢复到疫情前的水平了。
We thank God that by the end of 2021, January 2021, the employment rate has returned to the levels prior to the pandemic.
但是受全球经济复苏的影响。国家人力部预计接下来的各行各业复苏的步伐将不太一致，甚至可能会出现停顿。
But because we are also affected by the global economic recovery, Ministry of Manpower expects the pace of recovery in our country and all the various industries will be affected if some of them may even come to a halt.
近期印度又经历了新一轮的疫情大爆发。
So recently, India experienced another wave of pandemic,
创下了全球新冠疫情当天确诊人数的最高纪录。
And it set a new world record for the number of single day infections.
当一天就有31万的新增病例。
Within a day, there were more than 310,000 new cases.
目前全球因冠病而死亡的人数已经超过了300万。
And all over the world, those who have succumbed and died from the pandemic, from the COVID-19, exceeded 3 million.
但随着各国疫苗的接种，重症和死亡的风险将会大大减低。
But because we have the vaccines now, the risk of death and severe illnesses from the virus may be greatly reduced.
大家都打了疫苗了吗
？Have you all been vaccinated?
不过打了疫苗可能还是有传染的风险的。
Even though you've been vaccinated, you still may be infected.
大家还得继续防疫。
So continue to be vigilant.
很无奈也很疲惫了。
It can be tiring and we can feel helpless.
疫情在各地的反反复复，一波又一波的爆发，让我国经济复苏的前景。变得很不明朗。
This continuing waves of outbreak in various countries all over the world has made our economic recovery really uncertain.
许多本地居民表示，因为压力过大，睡眠不足，睡眠不足又带来精神健康的问题。
Many Singaporeans have said that the stress and the lack of sleep, resulting from the pandemic, has caused a lot of mental health issues.
根据新加坡友邦保险公司最新的一项调查显示
，So according to a recent survey by an insurance company in Singapore,
30到55岁之间的工作人士因为担心工作不稳收入减少，10个人当中9个人都说他们的精神健康有所下降。
So they did a survey of working people between the ages of 30 to 55. 9 out of 10 actually said that their mental health has been affected and is deteriorating because of their fear of job instability and loss of income.
新常态下的各种措施限制不但在我们工作上、学习上、生活上带给我们诸多的不便和一定的压力，而且也直接影响到我们的教会生活。
Under this new normal, all these measures and restrictions not only affected not only causing a lot of inconvenience and pressure to our work, our studies, our life, but it's also affected church activity.
就拿我们的教会来说吧，聚会时间缩短，还得注意保持安全距离。
So even directly affected our church. You know, you see how our time of gathering has shortened, and we continue to have safe distancing.
教会巴士服务的暂停也给我们年长的弟兄姐妹来教会带来一些的麻烦和拦阻。
So even the transport that brings our members to the church has the bus service has stopped, and that has caused a lot of inconvenience for people to come to church.
在疫情中受苦是我们人类共同的经验。
Suffering during this pandemic is a common experience for all of us.
作为信徒，作为基督的门徒，我们活在这世上，也无法避免受苦。
So as believers and disciples of Christ, we too cannot avoid the suffering.
甚至为着我们所信的这个信仰，还要多受些苦楚。
And because for the faith that we have in Jesus Christ, we may even suffer more.
但是只要我们认清神所赋予我们受苦的意义，我们就不会白白受苦。
But if we recognize the true meaning of suffering given to us by God, we will not suffer in vain.
反而可以得着意想不到的好处，反而能在苦难的处境中靠主得胜。
But instead, we may just reap unexpected gains and benefit with the help of the Lord, and we can overcome.
其实苦难对我们基督徒、对教会来说并不陌生。
You know, suffering is not unfamiliar to Christians and to the church.
教会就是从苦难中起家的嘛。
The early church started in the midst of suffering.
大家都还在读《使徒行传》，对吗？
We are all still reading the book of Acts.
最先开始的是教会的元首基督耶稣遭逼迫受鞭打，最后被钉死在十字架上。
It started with the head of the church, Jesus Christ, who was persecuted, who was flogged, and who was crucified.
而后跟随他的门徒也都遭受了不同程度的逼迫和苦难。
And then his followers followed up by being persecuted and also suffered.
甚至为主殉道。
And even being martyred for the Lord.
你们知道谁是第一位为主耶稣基督殉道的呢？
Do you know who is the very first martyr for the Lord?
非常好，说明你非常认真地读《使徒行传》，为你感谢主。
So I hear Stephen says the answer. So yes, we're so happy that you have been reading the Acts and following closely.
是的，斯提凡是第一位为主殉道的。
Indeed, Stephen was the first martyr for the Lord.
后来十二使徒几乎全部都为主殉道，除了使徒约翰。
And eventually, almost every of the 12 apostles were martyred, except for Apostle John.
使徒保罗更是遭受了各种的磨难，最后也是为主殉道。
And Apostle Paul also suffered a lot of hardship, but eventually he also succumbed to martyrdom.
还有初期教会300年间在罗马政府的10次大逼迫中为主殉道的人不计其数。
And there were also countless martyrs during the 10 persecutions of the early church by the Roman authorities over 300 years.
初期教会就是在逼迫苦难中成长和发展壮大的。
Yet the early church continued to grow despite the persecution and suffering.
若是让我们来了解一下初期教会的基督徒是如何在逼迫患难和苦境中得胜的秘诀，必定对处于苦疫情苦境中的我们大有帮助。
If we get to know the secret as to how the Christians in the early church overcame in the plight of persecution and adversity, it will certainly help us cope and overcome this plight of our pandemic.
好，现在就让我们来看雅各书一章二到十二节。
Now let us look at the book of James, chapter 1, verses 2 to 12.
让我快快地来读一下。我的弟兄们，你们若在百般试炼中都要以为大喜乐，因为知道你们的信心经过试验就生忍耐，但忍耐也当成功，使你们成全完备，毫无缺欠。你们中间若有缺少智慧的，应当求那厚赐于众人也不斥责人的神，主就必赐给他。只要凭着信心求，一点不疑惑，因为那疑惑的人就像海中的波浪被风吹动翻腾。这样的人不要想从主那里得着什么，心怀二意的人在他一切所行的路上都没有定见。卑微的弟兄升高就该喜乐，富足的降卑也该如此，因为他必要过去，如同草上的花一样。太阳出来，热风刮起，草就枯干，花也凋谢，美容都消磨了。那富足的人在他所行的事上也要这样衰残。忍受试炼的人是有福的，因为他经过试验以后必得生命的冠冕，这是主应许给他，给那些爱他之人的。
So verses 2 onwards, consider it pure joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you face trials of many kinds, because you know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance. Let perseverance finish its work so that you may be mature and complete, not lacking anything.If any of you lacks wisdom, you should ask God, who gives generously to all without finding fault, and it will be given to you. But when you ask, you must believe and not doubt, because the one who doubts is like a wave of the sea, blown and tossed by the wind. That person should not expect to receive anything from the Lord. Such a person is double-minded and unstable in all they do. Believers in humble circumstances ought to take pride in their high position,But the rich should take pride in their humiliation, since they will pass away like a wild flower. For the sun rises with scorching heat and withers the plant, its blossoms fall, and its beauty is destroyed. In the same way, the rich will fade away even while they go about their business. Blessed is the one who perseveres under trial, because having stood the test, that person will receive the crown of life that the Lord has promised to those who love him.
雅各书的作者是主耶稣基督肉身的弟弟雅各。
The author of the book of James is James himself, the biological brother of Lord Jesus Christ.
起初他并不相信他同母异父的哥哥耶稣就是基督神的儿子。
At the beginning, he would not believe that his half-brother, Jesus Christ, was the Christ and the Son of God.
他当时认为哥哥耶稣出去传道带门徒是癫狂了。
When Jesus went out to preach and make disciples, James thought of his brother as someone of unsound mind.
直到主耶稣从死里复活后，特地的向他显现，他才信了主。
And only until after the risen Lord appeared to him in person, then he believed.
生命经历了奇妙的改变。
And his life was transformed wonderfully.
以后做了神和主耶稣基督的仆人。
And then he became a servant of God and of Lord Jesus.
成为了耶路撒冷教会的领袖。
And became a leader in the church in Jerusalem.
不但牧养耶路撒冷教会的信徒，也关心因逼迫而分散在各处的犹太信徒。
Not about those Jewish believers who has been scattered due to the persecution.
以书信的方式来坚固他们的信心。
And he wrote letters to encourage and build their health, the faith.
雅各的这份书信首先以刚才我们所念的这段经文来鼓励当时的信徒。
So from the verses we read earlier, is from the book of James, and through these letters, he used them to encourage the believers at that time.
要在各样试炼苦境中喜乐忍耐坚持到底。
He told them to be joyful and to be patient and persevere in the midst of all kinds of trials and hardships.
这些话就像一首得胜苦难的诗歌，让信徒以生命来歌唱。
So these words are like a poem that actually talked about victory in the midst of suffering, so that these followers can actually sing praises of the Lord as they live.
成为真正的得胜者
，so that they become true conquerors.
其实这些的话也是向我们现今所有在逆境中、在苦难中的信徒所说的。
And these words, in fact, can be meant for us, we who are in the midst of suffering.
特别是现今处在疫情疲惫中的所有的信徒。
And especially so during these times when we are all being exhausted by this prolonged pandemic.
这些话对我们是特别的宝贵。
These words are so precious to us.
好，让我们先来看看这首得胜之歌的主歌第一段。
So let us look at verse 1 of this Song of Victory.
试炼中以苦为乐。
When you face trials, consider it pure joy.
雅各说，我的弟兄姐妹们，你们落在百般试炼中，都要以为大喜乐。
So James says that consider it pure joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you face trials of many kinds.
这里的试炼指的是我们人生中所遭遇到的各种的逆境苦境。
The trials referred here is referring to the adversities and the sufferings that we encounter in our lives.
当时这些分散在各地的犹太信徒面对信仰上的逼迫和不安定的生活。
At that time, these scattered Jewish believers were being persecuted for their faith, and they were experiencing a life of upheaval and adversities.
经历着各种各样的逆境。
And they went through a lot of suffering.
雅各说，我们所遭遇的各种试炼是无可避免的。
James said that these trials that we have to face are inevitable.
但是我们却可以以此为喜乐，而且是大大的喜乐，是全然的喜乐。
But we can consider this as pure joy, pure and a complete joy.
这听起来多少都有违人的常识，在苦境中怎么能开心地享受我们的苦难呢？
What he said didn't quite make sense because how can anyone suffer?You know, and us to enjoy the suffering.
而且还是大大的喜乐。
And not just enjoy, but to treat it as pure joy.
其实雅各不是要我们因试炼、因苦难本身而喜乐。
Well, actually, James didn't want us to be happy about the trials and the suffering.
他说的是，当我们以上帝的眼光、上帝的视角来看待我们的试炼、看待我们的苦难。
But he was telling us that we should look at our trials and our sufferings from the angle and the perspective of God.
雅各接着在第三节告诉我们，因为知道你们的信心经过试验，就生忍耐。
He went on to say that in verse 3 that.Because you know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance.
雅各说，我们应当因苦难，让我们的信心经过考验，产生忍耐，来欢喜快乐。要因苦难，让我们属灵生命得到益处，而大大的喜乐。
So James was saying that we will develop this character of perseverance through the testing of our faith from suffering, and we will be glad when our spiritual life benefits from it.
所谓刀不磨不锋利，人不磨不成器。苦难真是神用来磨练我们的信心，塑造我们的品格，使我们灵命成长最有效的工具。
So it is the same goes that knives have to be sharpened in order to be sharp, and a man can only become useful if he's been going through lots of trials and challenges. So suffering is the mostEffective tool that God has used to hone our character, to shape our character, and to enable us to grow spiritually.
神要使用苦难来成就他在我们身上的美好旨意。
God wants to use suffering to achieve His beautiful purpose for us in our lives.
接下来雅各在九节到十节讲的话似乎也蛮奇怪的。
Following James, continue in verse 9 and 10, verses 9 and 10, and these verses are also quite strange to us.
卑微的弟兄升高，就该喜乐。十节，富足的降卑，也该如此。
So believers in humble circumstances ought to take pride in their high position, but the rich should take pride in their humiliation.
社会地位卑微，贫穷的弟兄现在富有了。地位提升了，是该喜乐。
The men who were from the lower social strata and are poor who became rich and elevated in their position should be happy.
可是富有的弟兄现在家道中落，没钱了，开始被人轻看了，也该喜乐吗？
But those who were wealthy before but now become poor and were looked down upon, should they also be happy?
接下去雅各就告诉我们有富有变为贫穷的人也该喜乐的原因。
And James went on to tell us why the rich who became poor should also be joyful.
在十节下半节他说，因为他必要过去，如同草上的花一样。十一节，太阳出来，热风刮起，草就枯干，花也凋谢，美容就消没了。那富足的人在他所行的事上也要这样衰残。
So it continued in verse 10 that since they will pass away like wildflower, for the sun rises with scorching heat and withers the plant, its blossoms falls and its beauty is destroyed.
在试炼中，我们若能认清今世富足的人和他所追求、所倚靠的一切，就像草上的花，清早花开，绽放美丽，太阳一出，热风刮起。就经受不住了，草先枯干，没了水分，花就凋谢了，一切美丽转眼消逝，是如此的短暂，是如此的不靠，不可靠。
So in the midst of our trial, if we can see clearly about how the rich and the worldly things that they are after, how these things are just like wildflowers.And they bloom so beautifully in the early morning, but when the scorching sun, the heat from the sun comes, and the strong wind blows, they will just without the water, they will wither, and they will fade, and they will die away. So in the blink of an eye, this beauty fades.
那么我们就不该为了失去财富而失去喜乐，反而要因我们有一位厚赐百物给我们享用的神可以依靠而欢喜快乐。
This goes to show us that we should not lose our joy because of the loss of wealth, but we must rejoice and be glad because we have a God who gives us all things to enjoy.
提摩太前书六章十七节告诉我们，你要嘱咐那些今世富足的人，叫他们不要心高气傲，也不要寄望在浮动的财富上，却要仰望那厚赐百物给我们享用的神。
It is said in 1 Timothy 6:17, Command those who are rich in this present world not to be arrogant, not to put their hope in wealth, which is so uncertain, but to put their hope in God, who richly provides us with everything for our enjoyment.
富有的人最容易犯的毛病就是骄傲。
Pride is the most common problem for the wealthy.
因为仗着有钱比别人富足就心高气傲。
Because they are rich and they become arrogant because they feel they're richer than others.
可是浮动的财富又告诉我们，财富是不定的，是不可靠的。
But we know that wealth is so transient and is uncertain and unreliable.
就如箴言二十三章五节所描绘的，你的眼睛注视在钱财上，钱财却不见了。因为钱财必长起翅膀如鹰，往天上飞往天上。
We also see in Proverbs 23 verse 5, Cast but a glance at riches and they are gone, for they will surely sprout wings and fly off to the sky like an eagle.
主耶稣也在马太福音六章十九节教导我们，地上的财宝会遭虫咬、贼偷，也会朽坏。
Lord Jesus also taught us in Matthew. Chapter 6, verse 19. Do not store up for yourself treasures on earth where moths and vermin destroy and where thieves break in and steal.
地上的财宝是把握不住的，是不可靠的。
The wealth that you accumulate on earth, you can never hold on to it forever.
中国有一句俗话叫三十年河东，三十年河西。
There's a saying in China that says, river flows east for 30 years and then west for 30 years.
中国有一条非常出名的河叫黄河。
So there's this famous river we know called the Yellow River in China.
黄河的河床很高。河床。
The water level is really high.
是因为在河床高是因为有很多的泥沙淤积在上面不断的堆积使得它的河床很高。
Okay. The riverbed is high because of the accumulation of sand and soil in the riverbed.
当那个雨季的时候
when the rain falls and accumulates
就会造成泛滥
and the river will overflow.
并且泛滥成灾
and the place will be flooded.
所以古时候为了要解决这个河水泛滥的问题常常会改道
So in the old days, in order to avoid this overflowing of the Yellow River, they will do some redirection of the river flow.
让那个水能够疏通到别处
So that the water will be directed to somewhere else.
所以你本来住在河东这个地方
So if you live in the east side of the river
可能你改了道以后可能你就住年你住河西三十年你住河东
So hence you can stay in the east for 30 years and then move to the west for 30 years
你的家从来没有改过
We may have stayed in our place for the longest time
这句话的意思就是告诉我们世事变化盛衰无常
This saying is trying to tell us that everything changes, so the rise and falls are just expected.
这次疫情所造成的经济衰退，必定又会带来我们市场行业的重新洗牌。
This economic recession caused by the pandemic will surely bring about a reshuffle in the market, in the industries.
有些人失去财富，有些人开始累积财富。
Some will lose their wealth and some will accumulate wealth.
所以即便我们在疫情中失去了生意失去了财富或是收入减少也不要失去喜乐
So even if we lose business or wealth or income during the pandemic, do not lose your joy.
因为世事就是如此盛衰无常
Because such are the facts of life that, you know, the ups and downs,Nothing is certain.
我们可以喜乐，因为我们可以继续的仰望那后赐百物给我们享用的神，他才是信实不改变的。
We can be joyful because we can continue to look to God, who richly provides us with everything for our enjoyment. He is faithful and unchanging.
他必供应我们一切所需，指引我们的方向，带领我们前面的道路。
He will supply all our needs.And lead us on the way ahead.
接下来，让我们来看这首得胜之歌的主歌第二段。
Now let's look at the second verse of this song of victory.
第四节，但忍耐也当成功，使你们成全，完备，毫无缺欠。
Verse 4 says, "Let perseverance finish its work, so that you may be mature and complete, not lacking anything."
这种也当成功的忍耐是一种完全的忍耐不是一时的忍耐而是忍耐到底
This kind of perseverance that leads to success is a complete type not momentary but all the way to the finish
这种忍耐不是消极被动的去忍受试炼而是主动积极不屈不挠的去应对各种逆境
It is not about being anxious and passive butAnd they've been made to endure these hardships, but it is a proactive type, an unyielding type of perseverance that you can use to deal with all kinds of adversity.
好像那打不死的小强。
It's like that invincible little strong man, like a cockroach that cannot be crushed.
要产生这样完全的忍耐，信心的试炼往往不是短期的。
And to produce such perseverance, these trials of faith are not short term,
而是长期的，不是一两种的试炼，而是各种各样的试炼。
But they are long-term trials, and not just one or two trials, but various, many kinds of trials.
叫我们的信心通过各样的考验，就必如金经。
So that our faith, we have to pass through all these trials, and we will be like refined gold.
产生完全的忍耐，直到神成就他在我们生命中的目标。
And it will produce complete perseverance.Until God achieves His purpose for our lives,
使我们的灵命长大成熟，生活见证无可挑剔。
So that we will grow in our spiritual life to maturity, and that our lives will become a testimony that is impeccable.
接下来，让我们来看这首得胜之歌的主歌第三段。
Now let's look at the third verse of the Song of Victory.
5-8你们中间若有缺少智慧的，应当求那后赐予众人也不斥责人的神，他就必赐给你。只要凭着信心求，一点不疑惑，因为那疑惑的人就像海中的波浪，被风吹动翻腾。这样的人不要想从主那里得胜。心怀二意的人，在他一切所行的路上都没有定见。
Verses 5-8 says, If any of you lack wisdom, you should ask God, who gives generously to all without finding fault, and it will be given to you. But when you ask, you must believe and not doubt, because the one who doubts is like a wave of the sea, blown and tossed by the wind. That person should not expect to receive anything from the Lord. Such a person is double-minded and unstable in all they do.
雅各在这里似乎要告诉我们，若你还是无法为所经历到的苦难能带给你灵性上的好处而喜乐。
James seems to be telling us here that if you are unable to rejoice in the spiritual benefits that you receive,
假如你还是很难接受逆境和灵性成长之间的关系，
if you still have difficulty understanding the relationship between adversity and spiritual growth,
若你还是感到惶恐、害怕和忧虑，
and if you still continue to be anxious and to be troubled,
那你就可以带着单纯的信心来求神。
Then you can come forward with a simple faith to ask God.
求他赐你属灵的智慧。
Ask him to give you spiritual wisdom.
这智慧就是以上帝的视角、上帝的观点来看待事物的能力。
This wisdom is the ability to look at things from God's perspective and to treat everything from his angle.
是从一个属天永恒的角度来看待我们的人生。
And we are looking at all this suffering and all these trials from a heavenly and eternal perspective.
我们大多数人都缺乏这样的眼光和观点。
Many of us lack this vision and this perspective.
所以我们只要凭信心不疑惑，将自己的困惑、无知、痛苦、烦恼都告诉神。
So by faith and without doubting, tell God if you're confused, you're troubled, you're ignorant, you're in pain, or you're suffering.
后赐众人也不斥责人的神必帮助你。
And the God who gives generously to all without finding fault will help you.
赐给你这种天上的智慧与恩典。
He will give you wisdom from above and the grace from him.
让你能将他的话语正确应用在你的实际生活当中
，so that you will learn to use the word his wisdom to live your life，
一步步的去经历他话语的真实和得胜疫情疲惫的能力
，and you will be able to experience the truth of his words and have the ability to overcome the fatigue during this pandemic.
接下来让我们来看这首得胜之歌的最高潮部分。
Now let's look at the climax of this song of victory.
副歌得胜试炼必得生命冠冕。
The chorus says, overcomers will receive the crown of life.
十二节忍受试炼的人是有福的，因为他经过试验以后必得生命的冠冕。这是主应许给那些爱他之人的。
It is in verse 12. Blessed is the one who perseveres under trial, because having stood the test, that person will receive the crown of life that the Lord has promised to those who love him.
弟兄姐妹们，在疫情中，也许你正在经历各样的失去。
Brothers and sisters, during this pandemic, many of us may have suffered a lot of losses.
也许 你在经历各样的磨难。
Or we may be going through hardship.
也许你正在苦境逆境中。
Or you could be, you know, suffering during the hard times or the adversities.
但是你不要害怕，不要惶恐。
But do not be afraid. Do not panic.
不要忧虑，也不要焦虑。
Do not be troubled and do not be anxious.
因为我们有厚赐百物爱我们的神可以依靠。
Because we have a God who gives generously to all.
有在我们身上有美善旨意的神可以仰望。
And we have a God who has beautiful purpose for us in our lives.
世上的一切都是短暂的，不可靠的。
Everything on earth in our lives are transient and not reliable.
唯有神是我们的依靠，唯有神是我们的盼望。
Only God is our ever help and ever present help and our eternal hope.
弟兄姐妹们，让我们在疫情当中各样的疲惫当中，一起来用生命唱诵这一首的得胜之歌。
So brothers and sisters, in the midst of this exhaustion and this helplessness or hopelessness, let us continue to sing praises.
让我们一起在试炼中以苦为乐。
Let us consider pure joy during trials.
让我们一起在试炼中忍耐到底。
Let us continue to persevere in the midst of trials.
让我们一起在试炼中凭信祈求。
And in the midst of trials, we continue to pray in faith.
乃至于我们可以得胜，得胜，得胜一切的试炼，必得生命的冠冕。
Because we know that we will overcome, and we will overcome and will receive the crown of life.
愿主赐福他的话语在我们当中。
May God bless the words that are spoken amongst us.